Communication technologies are at the foundation for sharing information in society today. But what is communication engineering? In this video, I will define communication engineering, describe the components of a communication system and how they are characterized, and introduce the metrics used to measure communication system performance. Engineers design things. Communication engineers design systems to share information. These systems include devices and the networks that link those devices together. So the internet, your mobile phone network, or even connecting two cans with a piece of string are all examples of communication systems. Any communication system has five fundamental components. At the two ends are the source and the destination. The source has a message that we need to deliver to the destination. To do this, the source passes its message to a transmitter. The transmitter embeds the message into a signal and transmits the signal into the environment. The environment is the physical space where the signal propagates. The receiver senses the environment to detect the propagating signal and recover the message for the destination. Communication engineers try to design or characterize each of these components. First, we need a way to represent the source's message. In modern digital communication systems, we usually do this by encoding the message into a sequence of binary ones and zeros. Second, the transmitter must be able to modulate a signal according to the encoded message. A very common simple modulation scheme is called on-off keying, which transmits the signal for a binary one and pauses transmission for a binary zero. Third is to know what happens or what could happen to the propagating signal. For example, the environment could alter the strength of the signal, usually weakening it and not making it stronger. It could produce echoes, it could have interfering signals present, or it could add noise. Fourth, the receiver must have a mechanism to detect the signal and demodulate it, for example, to recover a sequence of ones and zeros. Finally, the demodulated signal is decoded to hopefully read the source's intended message. Now, given a communication system, communication engineers try to measure or predict important performance metrics. Metrics can include how much information can be transmitted at once. We refer to this as the capacity. How fast the information can propagate, we call this the delay between the transmitter and receiver, and whether the message decoded by the receiver is different from the source's original message. We usually measure this as a probability of error. The main performance constraint is the environment, but limitations also exist at the transmitter and receiver, for example, if they don't know the current state of the environment. If you tried to think of examples of communicating devices, then you'd probably think of modern inventions like phones, computers, and TVs. We can also apply communication engineering design and analysis to living devices like biological cells. Now you may wonder why would anyone bother treating cells like communicating devices, but that's a good question for another video. Thanks for watching. I hope you learned something. You can like the video and leave feedback in the comments. Consider subscribing if you'd like to see more research highlights and tutorials on biophysical communication engineering. See you next time.